this is Nikki D with Nikki D and OJ TV News, and I am here live at the Hybristophilia movie premiere, and it's going to be a great event. We have some big name actors and actresses, Vita Ghaffari, Quentin Aaron. It's also produced and directed by Romaine Simon. It's going to be a very big event, so stay tuned after this. And I am here with the big, big star, Vita Ghaffari. This is my third time interviewing her. Hopefully she doesn't get tired of me. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. You are the Duke and Duchess of Stockton, all Stockton media, so it's an honor to be interviewed by you guys.
Thank you. I feel like royalty just by you saying that.
Your eyes sparkle, so you look even more regal.
Thank you. You look so regal. I'm loving the gown. As soon as I saw you, I was like, oh my.
It's the gown.
I was like, Vita.
The lovely Sai Suman, who's here, is my wonderful guest. She designed my gown. She's an international celebrity designer of haute couture fashion. Lovely gal, very well educated in all things fashion, because you know I have a fashion blog. She's an international designer. Yes, you do, I noticed. Thank you. She went to school in London. She studied and worked in Dubai as well. She is truly a world-class designer, and she's right here. Sai,
Come on over. So this is Sai. Hello, how are you?
Good.
So tell me the inspiration behind this design.
Oh, she's so beautiful. You don't need an inspiration to design anything for this girl.
It does. The gown makes all women beautiful. Her gowns make all ladies beautiful.
But isn't she looking like an Egyptian queen right now?
Oh, I feel like it.
I love her features, her look. So I thought this is apt. You know, the black and gold, especially it complements her complexion. So pretty.
I always say H2T. Head to toe, you know.
What I love about her designs is the comfort of it. You would have never guessed. I have no Spanx or anything, which is a rarity. I'm very honest. I'm very upfront. I didn't even need to wear a bra with this. It's very comfortable. Mostly couture isn't comfortable, but it's very comfortable. It's very light. I feel great in it.
It flows very nicely.
Yes, I like it.
Give us a little background on you. How did you start designing and your experience with that?
I'm actually a science student. I never dreamt that I would actually get into this field of design, but like I always want to do something creative, and it was like just one thing that I believed in before I die. I want people to know me, know my creativity around the world. So that's how I started designing. I did my schooling from London College of Fashion. And Dubai, I did in New York at FIT. So, and then I designed in Dubai Fashion Week. I did Mercedes-Benz in New York, Australia, Europe. So a lot of places.
Truly international. Yeah, very. Like the World Bank or, you know, the UN. Yeah, UN of fashion.
We need you in Stockton.
You're the Duchess of Stockton Media.
we need some design. Is there anything you'd like to tell the community today?
Well, you know, Sai has some amazing shows coming up. If you want to expound on that a little, or
sure, I'm actually even launching my online shopping, which is going to be from first week of April, and guys can shop from www.saisuman.ws. Can follow on my social media. That's Instagram, saisumancouture. Sai Suman Couture in Twitter and Facebook. I'm coming up with a show which is going to be at Beverly Hills Sofitel in April of 11th. So it'll be cool. You guys should come.
It's a fashion show?
Of course.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, we're there. We love fashion shows.
Los Angeles was not yet ticked on my list, so you know, I wanted to do it.
Yeah,
everybody but Los
Angeles. Everywhere else you've done.
Oh, then you have to. Everybody but Los Angeles, go figure. Usually people go to Los Angeles, but that's good. Thank you so much for doing this interview.
Sure, I just want to add that Sai brings couture to the city of t-shirts and blue jeans and flip-flops.
Right on.
So I think it's very important, especially nowadays, younger designers mostly just design casual wear. So it's great to see a young designer doing high-end couture. One-of-a-kind pieces, handmade.
Yes,
it's so true.
She is such a good compliment giver. I swear.
But also we're here. We are also here for the premiere of my film Hybristophilia, which stars Quentin Aaron from The Blind Side. He worked with Sandra Bullock. I have a nice cameo role as Sabrina Sanchez, roving reporter, much like yourself.
She's playing a reporter.
Yes. I'm very excited. It's a great cast. Iyad Hajjaj from Madam Secretary, Massey Ferland from the Batman movie. Jenna Willis from the O.J. Simpson show, Sadie Katz from Wrong Turn 6. So it's a great ensemble cast. Romaine Simon did an outstanding job. It's my second horror premiere this week, and it's my second horror premiere this week at a Lemley.
Wow.
So I wish there was stock in Lemley. I'd buy it. Big thanks to also to the wonderful cast and crew of Holy Terror. We had our premiere Tuesday night. That's going to go on Amazon Prime April 1st, exclusively for a month. So I'm very excited about that.
Just busy, busy, busy.
Keep
busy.
One of the
most busy.
He's pretty. Oh, thank you.
So it works. Well, thank you very much. I hope you enjoy your night. Congratulations. And you are?
Yura Chen.
Angelica Nimba.
Olga Rogers.
Bring you all out this evening?
I'm coming out to support my producer friend that did this movie, and you know, it's I can't wait to see it.
Yeah. What do you look forward to the most in this film?
I'm not so much into horror. I'm just here for the support.
Okay, yeah. Personally, yeah. So I don't know. I might be closing my eyes the whole time. Yeah. But
this is one of the stars. Come on over here.
Hello.
What's your name?
Lillian Liv.
And you're in the film?
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about your role.
You guys have to see it by yourself. But
oh, that's you're good.
That's the main character.
You're good.
You're good. It's not a victim.
No. Okay. Is there something I can expect? Can you give me a little teaser?
Somebody with a little mental problems.
Okay.
But pretty good at what she's doing.
So it's not scary. It's just not
scary very much. You better believe that.
Did it scare you?
You mean like
watching it? Or being in it even?
Actually, yeah. Okay. A little bit.
You're scared or you're in it. I better be scared.
I mean, I always scared of myself, but, you know.
I would be scared too.
And now I'm scared of you.
Yeah, right? How do you handle something like that, like getting over your fears but playing the role in the film?
Well, I'm a professional actress. That's what I learned when I studied my acting, first of all. And second one, I just enjoy what I'm doing because I love acting.
And what can we look for next from you?
Next is going to be action movie. That's what I'm working on, actually two of them. It's going to be a lot of martial arts, and it's a superhero.
Are you the superhero?
Yes.
Look at you, go girl. Really? You're in it too?
Yeah. And Angie is in it as well.
When does this movie come out?
We don't know yet. It's being filmed still.
Okay. And you're in it too? What is your role in it?
I'm also doing some martial art action parts, and so, yeah.
Do you have to do some sort of special training for that?
No,
I'm from Germany, and I'm a professional stuntwoman actress too, and so that's...
And she's an MMA champion in Europe, and she studied in Shaolin, so she's badass.
Oh, okay, so probably kick everybody's butt up here. I need you to go everywhere.
This is, she's going to be our PR person.
Just supporting my friends.
Okay. And what are you looking forward to the most in this film?
Close my eyes.
I'll be right there with you.
Hi, I'm Brooklyn Robinson.
And what brings you here today, Brooklyn?
What brings me here today is I play a character. I play the flashback of young Janet.
Okay. Young Janet. How did you get a role like this?
I got auditioned for it, and then when I booked it, I was like, oh my gosh! And then when we heard we were filming in Big Bear, I was like, oh, that sounds fun!
That does sound fun. Was it snowing? Does it snow there?
It was actually like a mountain.
Oh, okay. Now, are you an experienced actress, or is this your first film?
I'm experienced.
So what other films are you in?
I'm in another one that's cast by the same director for High Sophia. It's called Blood Runs Thick.
Is it another horror film?
Yes.
So you're getting all these scary movies in, huh?
Yeah.
You're going to be so tough. I love your gown, by the way. Who designed it, or do you know who designed it?
I think it's maybe Ula La Couture.
I've heard of them.
Yeah, they're really amazing.
Yeah, it is. It looks really good on you. And tell the people, how old are you?
I am 9 years old.
You are a smart 9 year old. How do you remember your lines? What is your technique and tips for that?
I'm just born with good memory.
My name is Christian Alexander Little.
And what brings you here this evening?
This evening, I'm just here because of my grandma. She's important because of here, because she's like, she's basically the reason why this movie is coming up, because she's, I can't say the word. She's just making this.
Is she heavily involved?
She's in charge, yeah.
Okay, so she's heavily involved. Is she like, So you got some stuff in your hand. Tell me what you got going on.
So I was in the Kids' Choice Awards Nickelodeon, as you see right here.
Yeah. That's a good picture of you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I think so, too.
Did you win an award, or how did that work?
No, I was just in the aviator groups.
Oh, okay. What does that mean?
The aviators are basically like Wonder Woman's and the flyers in the ship try to defeat the Wonder Woman's, and it's like a laser battle with gauntlets.
So what is it that you're trying to pursue career-wise?
Excuse me?
Like, what do you want to do for a career?
For a career? I want to stop bullying. That's why I'm an advocate for anti-bullying.
Okay. So you're an advocate for anti-bullying. What would you suggest would be one of the best ways to stop bullying?
To stop bullying, I would think, like, send all of the bullies to a proper camp to, like, make them stop. Just make
to educate them and rehabilitate them from bullying, right? You don't want to punish them necessarily, but rehabilitate them from bullying. I like it. I like it. So tell me a little bit about your outfit. What was the inspiration for this outfit? It's very different. It's fashion forward, you know.
This outfit was basically, this was from my grandma.
Okay.
If she could come over here.
This is grandma.
Hi, how are you?
We're talking about his outfit.
Oh, okay.
And how old are you?
I am almost like 10 years old.
Almost like 10, cool. I'm almost like 24. Yeah.
Seth Carr.
Hey, Seth Carr, how you doing?
Good.
I like your watch. So I heard you were in a film or a movie. And it's kind of a big deal. What were you in?
Black Panther.
How was that?
It was a cool experience.
How did you get to become an actor?
My mom told me I was sitting on the living room couch, and I just told her I wanted to be on TV, and she called some friends, and they started me.
So you said you want to be on TV, and your mom hooked it up. Awesome. I told my mom that. She was like, oh, girl, you're so crazy. But how old are you?
I'm 9.
You're only 9? Is acting what you want to do as a career?
Yeah.
You know what? You got a good face for that acting. See what you did right there? You go with everybody. Don't do reality TV, though. It's for the birds, okay? Don't do it. No reality shows, okay? So what brings you to this movie premiere specifically? Are you involved in the movie, or do you just really want to see the movie?
Well, we just like going to events to just see how the other actors, like do the movies, and I just want to, like, if I need to do that character, I just need to know how to do that and feel the character.
So how do you study for a role?
I just, like, watch some TV shows or the shows that I'm going to be doing.
Princess Map.
And how old are you?
10 years old.
And I heard you were in a movie and it's kind of a big deal. Tell me about that.
Okay, so it's not a movie, it's a commercial.
Oh, it's a commercial.
And it's a Serena Williams commercial, a Gatorade. And they flew me all the way to Miami, Florida. It was amazing.
It was amazing? You got to go to Miami?
Yeah.
Wow, how was that? Did you get to swim and all that?
No.
Oh, yeah. You don't want to
get that. Yeah, because I had to work and everything.
It's work. I know. So you're doing commercials now. Are you going to be in more commercials? Are you going to do movies? What are you going to do?
Oh, I have a movie, too, called Divine Creed.
Okay.
It's, like, about... like this woman and the dad divorce and everything. I'm the stepsister.
Oh, okay, you're the stepsister. And I see you are wearing a sash. Tell me a little bit about that. You're Miss
African-American Queen.
Okay. And what are the qualifications to be that?
Well, it's a young lady, like a really young, responsible lady.
Okay.
And you have to be really responsible.
What makes you so responsible? Pay your bills on time.
Well, I, like, represent these people.
Yeah. Well, you have to be responsible to to go around and wear the sash and the tiara. You have to look good all the time and be respectable and have dignity all the time. So when people see you with this, they automatically should respect you. So you have to act accordingly, right?
Because I look like a queen.
You are.
Eric Zulli. I play Josh in the film. This is my lovely date, Isabel.
Hi, very nice to meet you.
She's also an actress and a model, makeup artist.
Wow, wow. So what kind of makeup do you do? Do you have a specialty?
I love doing all natural makeup, making you look abnormally perfect, but I also love doing show makeup as well.
Like perfect, but like times 10, basically. Love it.
You wake up like Beyonce, you're flawless.
Okay, like you just rolled over, you're like, ta-da, you know. And so tell me about your role in the film.
I played Josh. I get killed twice. Actually, while I was shooting my part, I actually did get hit in the face with the axe. It hurt. But you know, I'm also an online positionist. I have, you know, my own YouTube, and people are not YouTube, but it's called Easy Way Tube, so it's kind of like YouTube.
Yeah, yeah.
People are making channels, and we're making a lot of things happen for a lot of people, a lot of doors right now.
Yeah, I've
shout out to my man
Romain.
Yeah, shout out to my man Romain. He's been my friend for over 10 years. Shout out to this outlet. I mean, I've been a big supporter of you guys for a while, and you know, I'm it's always cool to be able to walk your own carpet and be able to, you know.
Be able to show your own stuff, something that you've been in.
Yeah.
How do I get some Easy Way gear?
How
can I get the swag?
You text the letters Easy Way to the number 21777, and you text me directly, because you know me. I hook you up. Give you.
All right.
You guys are, you know, awesome. So
if
we'd love to give you guys some gear and rock some Easy Way, support us.
We got shirts. We got sweaters, hats. Gonna become a shoe line jewelry. I don't know yet. I'm trying to get that in motion.
Give it all to me. I'll wear it. I'll post it on my Instagram.
This movie is really awesome. Quentin Aaron's been my friend for close to 8 years. You know, he stars in the film. Lily's my friend. I mean, watch, just being on set with your friends and watching what they're doing.
Natural.
It's really good movie. I'm very proud of Romain. I've known Romain for years, and to see people not talk about it but walk about it, especially in Hollywood, is really awesome.
Angelica Kaufman, Joyce.
I understand you have a role in the film.
Yes, I was playing secret, maybe. Playing mother of a main actress.
Okay, how did you like playing that role?
Oh, wow, it was stressful, you know, because I have to be in the character, you know, it's a horror movie, of course, a lot of blood, and, you know.
Are you a little scared of the blood, or?
No, not really, but, you know, I wouldn't be a doctor, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
My son is a doctor, but
oh,
I'm
wow.
not.
Okay, so I also love your whole outfit, your gown and everything. Do you know who designed it, or can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yes, I have a friend of mine. She lives in Northern California. She designs dresses for me sometimes, you know, for my special events.
That's so wonderful. And will you be seen in other movies coming up soon?
Yeah, yeah. We're working on another movie. It's a woman's in the man's world. And, you know, we also working on Blood Runs Thick with the same director, Roman Simon. And my husband is about coming over soon. We are a celebrity real estate power couple. So our day job is real estate. And
wow, you just do it all.
Yeah, we do it all.
I love it.
Zane Hubbard.
And what brings you here today?
I'm just here to you know, support my buddy with hyperphilia. Yes.
You know what does that word even mean?
I'm really not sure, but you know, he's a great friend of mine. He helped me on my project, Chronicles of Jessica Wu.
So tell me a little bit about your project.
Sure. It's a web series that we're doing. It's a superhero story.
Okay.
It's about this young girl who's she's on the autistic spectrum, and she has, you know, these abilities to you know, beat her competition up and mathematically you know, size up everyone. It's a brilliant story. It's a heartfelt story.
How did, like, what was the motivation to come up with a story like that? Because that's very specific.
Well, yeah. My daughter, she's autistic, and you know, she's a big inspiration to me. And I just looked at her. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna write a good story. And that's exactly what I decided to do.
Mr. Brandon Larkins from HBO's The Wire, producer of Monogamy and TBS's Cougar Town.
Oh, you're just in it all. What brings you out tonight?
Well, working with Mr. Romain Simon, we're co-producing on a series called The Chronicles of Jessica Wu. You've already talked to Zane Hubbard, our director. Simon has brought in a wealth of knowledge, and he is our stunt choreographer and coordinator for all the fight scenes and all the action scenes. You know, and we're just here to support one another. You know, he supports my show, I support his show. We work on a project together. We're networking with so many people, and it's just about bringing good, positive energy, you know.
Wow. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. So what you have this project coming up, and you're in all these things. What can we expect next from you after that? You got anything?
You know what? To be honest with you, I really enjoy producing, okay. And I like giving other individuals the same opportunities that I received when I first started my career. You know, employing actors, employing a film crew, someone who's a sound person, someone who's a cinematographer or a DP, a publicist for a project.
And you are?
My name's Eric Merrill. I'm one of the actors in the film.
What is your role in the film?
I actually play one of the guys that tries not to get killed.
And are you successful?
Well, you have to watch the movie.
Oh, you're good. You guys are good today.
Right.
You guys are on your game.
I can't give away all the secrets, right?
So aside from this film, what can we see you in next?
I was in Life of Gia. That was not too long ago. That won some independent film festival awards.
Right.
And then I know they're casting for Red to Black, and looks like I'll be working in that. So.
Okay. Hi, Ina Fisher.
So what brings you out this evening?
I'm an actress and producer. I've been invited by Ramon to attend this to support him, and I've supported before as well.
Okay. What are some of the movies you've been in?
I have been in The American Dream, Predatory Lander, American Style, and Guest House of the Dead that I'm working on.
I'm here with?
My name's Joe Williamson.
Frank Perez Jr.
And what brings you guys out this evening?
I'm out here for the premiere. I'm excited to see this film, and it's an amazing cast, and I think it's going to be great.
Yeah, I'm here to cover the story because I have my magazine called California Special Edition News Magazine, and I also have Pinas, where we have 7 million followers to read that. And I also here with Joe. He invited me here. So
tell me a little more about your magazine.
Magazine is for martial arts magazine, but we put everything that are in movies, any movies that are entertainment, because martial arts is entertainment. And we put a lot of movies in there on the front page, you know, so that's why it's good.
And I like your suit.
Oh, thank you so much.
Do you have anything you want to say?
Just excited about this film, and it's an honor to see you again. I remember we met at the Roman Simons.
The rap party.
Yes. So just excited about this, and
I made it back down here.
I'm glad, and it's gonna be a great scary movie in that. And what I do is I'm a producer, manager, and publicist.
Okay.
You know, there was a film called Holy Terror. We just had a private a screening for what was that, a couple days ago? Or?
Right.
Yeah.
Holy Terror.
Yeah. Once again, starring Vita Gafari, Mel Novak, and that's out right now. And then there's another film, Checkpoint,
okay.
And that's out on DVD every place.
Okay.
Target, Walmart.
Are you on the social media?
Yes. Go to Williamson, The Williamson Management on Facebook.com, and that's Facebook. And you'll find me.
This is none other than Lucky Strike Films' very own Romain Simon. How are you doing this evening?
Well, that's a big title you put on me, making it happen. You know, I wouldn't be able to make it happen without everyone that's including yourself and Jose Orlando, everyone that came here and to support the film. I'm just excited. Everybody get to enjoy the film. Our actress is right over there. You know, she's wonderful. So I'm just excited for more to come.
I'm really excited for you. I've barely known you this year, or since maybe October, maybe. And your list of work is really fascinating to me. And the type of quality you put out, I think, is really good. And really an example for the rest of the community of hard work. And what is your motivation for the types of films you do?
I pull a lot of those motivation, a lot of those stories from way back on my roots where I came from. You know, like I said before, a lot of the things that people had to deal with is not really drama, it's horror. You know, a female, for example, getting raped is horror. And somebody has to live with that, you know, over and over again throughout their life. A kid, you know, deal with bullying or deal with domestic violence in the family. So if somebody really pay attention to my film, you will see, wow, this is really life, you know. And people that struggle to become who they are, because I know we will never be able to satisfy human beings in 100%. You know, you are always either, you know, too tall, too short, too white, too black, too this, you know. So, but I do films about those things.
Yeah.
you know, and to be able to tell the story for people to come and have Abu Sofika, Abu Sikai, who come to support me, support the Red Carpet, and everybody around Lucky Strike Film is just amazing.
Kwejo Obeng.
Welcome, welcome. What brings you out this evening?
My friend invited me to come and see this movie. Very exciting. I enjoyed it, and I'll see it when it's finally released. I met them when they attended the African Film Festival, and I had a new magazine, Pan-African Magazine.
Tell us about more about your magazine.
It's a magazine that is going to introduce all African people to our history, our culture, our identity. As African people, we have lost a lot. Everything has been taken away from us. We know more about other people, our conquerors, than we know about ourselves. And we are not making any effort to learn about who we are so that we can determine how we got here and how to chart a course for the future.
This has been Nikki D. It's a wrap.
Yes.